Big Ten Conference Tournament bracket looks like this. We played four games. Iowa advancing to face number one seed Maryland. That was game one of day two. And game two of day two, Northwestern advancing to take on the four seed Indiana. One of the quarterfinal games that we'll show you on Friday. Shelly Till and Lisa Byington with you. Well, Northwestern, they've been a Jekyll and Hyde team all season long, but they've looked pretty good in this conference tournament here so far.
Well, they certainly have, and they've picked the right time to play the kind of basketball that they're playing. And it's a brand of basketball that's driven by passion, by heart, and they're laying it all on the line. And I loved Coach McEwen's comment about how no one cares who gets the credit, and that's the way they played today, and they made unselfish plays, especially down the stretch.
I love Coach McEwen's comment to Christy Winter Scott after this game. I'm going to go to Rachel Banham's graduation to make sure that she does officially graduate. Why? The last time they played, Banham poured in 60, but it was a tough go of it today. 26 for her, but on 7 of 25 shooting.
Yeah, she just really couldn't get going in the rhythm that we've seen Rachel Banham accustomed to, and she tried. She gave it her all to try and connect on shots, but just really couldn't get anything going. And you do have to give some credit to Northwestern defensively. I thought that they were all over her. They did switches on her. They had double teams and triple teams on her, and it worked.
Gave her zero space. Really made it a tough afternoon for Rachel Banham, who was the first Big Ten player to actually reach 3,000 career points this afternoon. Nia Coffey, the Minneapolis native, really went to work against the Minnesota team. She put up another double-double this afternoon.
Yeah, I was so impressed with the play of Nia Coffey today. She did it everywhere, all over the floor, and played with such poise in that pretty pull-up jump shot, and she's hitting threes. She was doing things in transition. She was getting steals. She had rebounds to go along with it. Four assists in this game. I mean, everything she needed to do. She was on the floor, and this is the most important thing, Lisa. She didn't foul out of the game. She played 39 minutes in this game. That shows the importance of having Nia Coffey on the court.